Hey, Master Gardeners. Here I am out in the woods, looking like a country girl, I guess. But if you want to be the best little nature, give the best little nature hiker, be the best little naturalist, you got to learn this tree. So, this is one of the birch trees, and it might be one that you've heard about before because they make beverages out of it. It's called birch beer because it has an oil in it that has a wintergreen type flavor. And back in the old days, they used to tap it and even ferment it to make that birch beer and all. But today, in the woods, it's a good one because you can snip off the little sticks and make a little toothpick out of it. And wow, can you impress your little hikers? You have to peel the bark off of it. But this is called Betula lenta. The common name is sweet birch, also called black birch, also called, what's the other one? Black birch, sweet birch? Cherry birch is the other one. And the reason it's called cherry birch is, if you want to look at this real close, you can see it has those horizontal lines in it, a lot like a cherry tree. So that's why it looks cherry-like. That's a big hint on how to identify it when you're in the woods, because it has the traditional birch-type leaf, which is definitely strong points on the ends, and the veins are real straight. So it looks just like a typical birch tree. You're not going to get it confused with things like river birch, because look at the bark. Look over there at the big trunk. You can see how it still has those horizontal lenticels on it. And actually, they get very black with age. So the dark color of the bark is another common name. And so black birch is why it's called that. But pretty nifty, beautiful fall color, kind of unique to be in our habitat here because it prefers mountainous regions. It's native all the way from Maine all the way down through Delaware. And then it kind of follows the Appalachian Mountains because it prefers mountainous type regions. They say it's listed as a full sun plant. It's one of your best birches for full color, fall color, because it gives you a beautiful golden color. And it is more resistant to the bronze birch borer, because birches have a lot of disease problems, but this one doesn't. So a nice pyramidal tree for the yard, good habitat for all your butterflies and moths, because we know from Ptolemy that this is one of the trees that a lot of the insects like. A lot of moths and butterflies. The morning cloak butterfly is one that prefers this particular species. But a pretty nifty tree to know. And once you learn it, you can nip off these little pieces. And let me tell you, what you have to do is get your participants to kind of peel off the bark, because the flavor is underneath. Once you peel the bark, once you get down inside there, that's really where the flavor is in it. And then you put it in, you chew it, and man, it's so aromatic. I don't know that the foliage has any aromatic smells, but it's a pretty cool plant to know. So sweet birch, nice one to know for our local native habitat. Come take a look.